Good morning. Love the hair.
Please don't ever mention my hair again.
Got it.
Ever.
The mid-90s, the women's hair all came forward.
Your word is gold.
Everything was brown in the 90s. Or there was, like, no eyebrow with a really dark lip.
There's a lot of hair in the show. There's a lot of design.
We try to do just these little subtle things without using prosthetics.
I love the collaborative process of working with everyone to create, you know, who this person is.
I spent a lot of time figuring out how to change the shape of his forehead just enough to look a little more like Robert Kardashian. Totally transforms him into another person.
Hair was the key component to figuring out the look. I have quite a high hairline, so we wanted to lower my hairline a little. And the silver streak in his hair is the most identifying feature to the coif that's happening there.
The numbers, 1 in 170 million.
The crime scene was mishandled.
It's just so overwhelming.
People know who these people are. They were everywhere in the media at this time. Everyone knows what Marsha Clark looked like.
Sarah's incredibly collaborative, and she's got an amazing eye.
She has a character makeup that just changes the shape of her eyes. She has a signature mole. She has 4 different style wigs. Everything has changed about her face and her lip shape and as much as we can to Marsha.
Oh, no, seriously?
My favorite look is actually the interim look where she has the very short kind of chia pet looking haircut. I think it actually is the best one. I might take it home at the end. Wear it around the house while I'm cleaning.
Nathan was willing to shave his head, which was a huge commitment. There were so many little things that went on with that makeup, with the wig also. He has fake eyebrows he has to wear.
He'll be dead and buried before he even knows what hit him.
Really, a lot of character work is about eyebrows for some reason. Everybody has an eyebrow thing. This much hair can make such a big difference on rub each eye.
Please, no pictures.
We have to be really careful about making sure that those Robert Shapiro eyebrows don't get too crazy.
The right marriage between what does Robert Shapiro look like, what does John Travolta look like, what are the most subtle things that we can bring together with his hairline, the way the eyebrows are shaped.
The wig was absolutely stunning. Robert tanned so much. He also had a lot of sun damage, and so we added that into John, because John's quite fair.
I think that there's just a few bad apples.
Unbelievable.
The first day, seeing him in hair and makeup, there was a moment of just, this is uncanny, this is incredible. But what's been great is watching them go beyond the hair and makeup, beyond the wardrobe, and create real characters out of these people.
One of the first things I knew I really wanted to do was to make sure my hair looked like Johnny's.
It's all part of this immersive process where all of a sudden I look in the mirror and, oh wait, I'm Bill Hodgman in 1995. You don't have to imagine anything, it is all there.
We have enough evidence to win 5 times over.
We did the hair, we did the beard. I put on the robe and the glasses and I kind of felt like Judge Ito.
Court is now in session. The Honorable Lance A. Ito presiding.
Maybe see it.